just got the full session. You're listening to Tina on the Big Rock Radio Show. Yeah, rock up your eyebrows. Alright, this is Shane from Dreams of the Blood, and I'm hanging with Tina from the Big Rock Show. The legions are growing, swelling
like a star. Hi everybody, this is Rob Halford, the Metal God, with my metal maiden Tina on the Big Rock Show. Turn it up. Memories of 68, when the wizard shook the
world. Metal came from foundries where the metal... Welcome to Season 6 of the Big Rock Show, with your host, Tina Peak.
Oh my god, yes!
New episodes, new music, and new interviews. For more information, check out thebigrockshow.net.
Good evening, friends, and welcome to a special edition of the Big Rock Show. And my special guest tonight is Ronny Munroe. We're going to have a great chat about his new album entitled Lords of the Edge. It's available for pre-order right now with a release date of October 18th. There's a free download available for one of the tracks, but only until October 17th. So pop over to his record label, Rat Pack Records, at www.ratpackrecords.com/Ronny Munroe. Grab the free download and then make sure you pick up your copy as soon as you can. I've listened to the whole disc and it is wicked sick. Ronny's voice sounds better than I've heard it since, well, the days of Metal Church. His last solo album, The Fire Within, was fantastic. But Lords of the Edge, it's going to blow you away. A 10 out of 10, without a doubt. I'll be asking Ronny all about this amazing new metal album, and I'm also going to see if he'll take some time to go over each of the tracks, just to give us a little insight into the songs. Ronny Munroe is, and always has been, about metal music. It's in his blood and it curses through his veins, so make no mistake, this album should be on the top of any metal lover's list. I'm going to play a couple of tracks off Lords of the Edge for you today, of course. The opening track called Just Breathe, and I'm thinking either The Vision or Pierced by the Maiden. We'll see what Ronny has to say about the songs, and maybe he'll let us in on which one is his favorite, and then I'll simply play that. So, turn it up. This record needs to be played loud. Then sit back and enjoy. Ronny will be with us shortly. And here's the opening track. It's called Just Breathe.
Welcome to the Big Rock Show. We're going to party our tits off today. I think you know that. I know that. The American people know that. It's going to be a great program. So just go ahead and squeeze your girth and sit back and listen.
Hey, Ronny. Welcome back to the Big Rock Show. How are you?
I'm doing great, Tina. Thanks for having me. Always good to be here.
Well, I love having you on the show because there's always something exciting going on at your end. And today is no exception. You've got a new solo album out entitled Lords of the Edge. It's available for pre-order as we speak with a release date of October 18th. Now, I've heard the new disc in its entirety and seriously, it's absolutely wicked, Ronny. Congratulations. Your best work to date, in my opinion.
Well, thank you very much. I'm extremely proud of this record, just like I was over The Fire Within and the work I did with Metal Church, of course. But this is, I feel, the next level. The Fire Within was good, but this one I just think is much better all the way around. The songs are better, the production, you know, just the whole thing. So I'm really stoked about the record, and I hope it does well.
Yeah, it's a great disc. So when did you begin working on Lords of the Edge? How did it all start?
Well, basically, you know, I started writing a little bit as soon as The Fire Within was done because that's what I do. I'm basically writing all the time. But when I finally hooked up with Stu Marshall, really, is when I decided to really go ahead and start the ball rolling. And Stu Marshall is a guy out of Australia. He used to be in Dungeon, and he's now in Empires of Eden. And basically, you know, I worked with him. So, and that was in, I believe, January when we started. So it all came together pretty quickly.
Well, you've got three amazing metal guitarists on the new disc. Chris Caffery of TSO and Savatage. Stu Marshall, as you just mentioned, of Empires of Eden. And once again, Michael Wilton of Queensryche. How were they brought in and what do you think they added to the feel and sound of Lords of the Edge?
Well, we'll start with Whip. You know, Whip's a friend of mine and of course, a great guitar player. He's a legend in the industry, and it's always nice to to be able to call on him and to have him want to play on my record. You know, so it was an honor, and Whip came in and did a great job, as always. Chris Caffery is a friend of mine as well. We toured together before and whatnot, and Chris is a great guitar player as well, and I gave him a call up one day and said, hey, would you like to contribute to the record? And he said, sure, and did some playing on it as well as contributing the song Rock in a Hard Place. And Steve Marshall, of course, as we mentioned before, basically he engineered, mastered, co-produced, you know, did this at his studio in Australia and whatnot, and Stu's playing is phenomenal, and also his songwriting, you know, so basically it's an honor to have all three of the guys, really, and I just can't wait for the fans to hear it and get their feedback on it.
Who else plays on the album, Ronny?
Well, there's Rick Ward on drums and my friend Jeff Baker on bass, you know, and Rick Van Zant from Metal Church as well played on one track.
Oh, really?
Yeah, as well as the guys that we just mentioned.
Okay. Now, you mentioned Stu Marshall co-produced Lords of the Edge with you. You also produced The Fire Within. Do you like that aspect of the work?
It's a different side of it. With the production thing, you know, you wear different hats. You know, you help with the songs, you know, the different parts, putting parts together, taking parts out, just overseeing things and whatnot. And you know, Stu is also very astute at doing that as well. And it was really a collaborative effort on that, and it just worked out really well. For whatever reason, there's certain times when you meet people and you start to work with them that it either works or it doesn't. And with Stu, man, I'm telling you, him and I are a lot alike as far as the work aspect. When we're doing something, we work until we get it done, until it's done right. He would send me things, a bunch of material, actually, he sent me, and I weeded through some of the stuff, and actually, I think it's like 8 tracks of the 12 really came from Stu, musically. Basically, I just took things and kind of dissected them here and there and got back to him, just sending him emails back and forth. You know, I'd wake up every morning to a completed song.
Wow.
About, you know, it was really cool. You know, as Stu would say, he always thought it was like Christmas when he'd get up and he'd see my, you know, my lyrics or the recordings that I would send him. And it was really the same for me because, like I said, the guy is not very well known yet, but he should be because the guy's a monster as far as knowing what he's doing. It's just been a very cool ride. I'm glad it's done because now we can move on and we're now, as we're doing interviews, talking about the record, hyping it and trying to get it out there. And like I said before, I just can't wait for the fans to hear this because I'm really excited about it. These are well-written songs, man. Heavy metal.
Yeah, you should be excited. And for the fans out there, you know, if you haven't taken a listen yet, go over to ratpackrecords.com/Ronny Munroe, and there's a free download on the site for all you metalheads out there. This really is, I know I say this a lot, I love the artists I interview and I love all the work that they do, but this disc, I mean, it's just beyond. It blows the roof off of The Fire Within, and I really loved The Fire Within. I just think this is a great piece of work, Ronny.
Thank you. I really appreciate that. I worked hard on it.
I bet you did. So now tell us about the title. Who came up with that? It's really killer. I love it.
Well, thanks. Well, I came up with that. And what that means, Lords of the Edge, to me at least, was, you know, basically even surviving in today's world, you've got to have a pair of balls, you know?
Right.
You really do. And we're living on the edge. So it's like, it's that as well as for people that take chances in life, you know, because if you don't take chances in life, you're never going to get anywhere, you know? So that's what a Lord of the Edge is. If you take chances and risks in life, you're a Lord of the Edge. And also, you're a Lord of the Edge just even existing in today's world. So that's kind of what's behind that.
Yeah, it's a great title. I love it. Now, we just spoke about your first solo, The Fire Within, and I thought it was amazing. And like I said, this one is just brutal. Great piece of work. Did you approach the writing and or the recording for Lords of the Edge differently than you did, say, for The Fire Within?
Yes, I did, actually. I decided when talking with Stu that, well, for obvious reasons, Stu lives in Australia. And number one, although I would have loved to have gone over there, that's a very expensive flight, and also I have other things that I have to take care of at home, so I wasn't able to do that. So we decided to do this record through the internet, which a lot of people are doing now, and I've got to say that, you know, I've always talked about the internet being a double-edged sword and whatnot. Basically, I decided to use the internet to my advantage. I had the tracks from all my guys and whatnot. They all recorded their parts, and we all sent them to Stu and myself, and Stu and I worked with them. And really, that's how this record was done, was through the internet.
Wow.
It's being done a lot these days, and I'm sure it's going to be done even more in the future, because as we know, the state of the music industry really sucks right now. You've got to find ways to work to your advantage, and I think I did that.
Yeah, you certainly did, and you're right about that. I mean, we've come a long way with the internet. You've got good people that happen to be in Australia, and you're out in Washington, out in Seattle. I mean, it does get expensive to fly back and forth, and the album sounds terrific. It just sounds like you guys were all in the same room. You'd never know.
Well, I appreciate that, and that is what technology does bring to us.
Yeah.
You know, and also, you know, as we already know, I'm not Metallica. I'm not one of these huge, huge bands that have that huge budget, and there's no need to even put on a facade about that or even white lies about that. It is what it is. And I'm very truthful about these things. Mm-hmm. The bottom line is here is if the product suffered or not. And it did not in my ears and my eyes.
No.
It turned out great. And I'm probably will continue to do this until one day I decide not to. But we'll see what happens. Right now the focus is on just Lords of the Edge, and we'll see what happens. Like I said, so excited. And it was actually really cool to be able to do it this way. I mean, just think about that.
Yeah.
When you're working with somebody all the way in a different continent, you wake up the next day and you've got a completed song. It's just very cool. So.
Yeah, it is cool and time-saving. So now, Ronny, your voice sounds really strong on this disc. Did you do something different with it by chance, prepare your voice differently at all? Because it does sound stronger on this disc than it even did on The Fire Within.
Well, no. You know what, actually, I think the reason for that possibly is I'm in a different climate. I'm actually in Puerto Rico right now. This is where I recorded the vocals, where I live. And of course, it's a lot hotter here. And for singers, you know, hey, being a singer is a tough thing. You know, like when I lived in Washington, you know, there's a lot of cold, there's a lot of rain. So I think that had something to do with it. Hmm. As well as I have my own studio here, and I recorded my vocals on my own. And when you're able to do that, when you're on your own, you don't have anybody, you know, staring you down or telling you this, that, you know, you're doing it on your own, you're much more relaxed and comfortable. I think that had a lot to do with it. And, of course, I would send my tracks on. I had a couple other pairs of ears that I would let listen to certain things that I thought maybe sounded funny or maybe could have been better, you know, just to get that extra opinion. And I just appreciate you saying that, because I think I sound, pretty decent on this record.
Oh, I think you sound a lot more than just pretty decent, my friend. I mean, seriously, I thought maybe you had done something differently with your voice, but that's interesting. And I guess, too, when you're doing that on your own, there really is no pressure on you. You could take your time, you can go over your own stuff. But I mean, on this, I don't know, your voice just sounds a little different, a little stronger than it did on your past disc.
Well, thanks. And, you know, as far as, like you mentioned, pressure, yeah, no pressure except for the only pressure that I put on myself, which I'm famous for that.
Right.
I'm somewhat of a perfectionist, and I want things to be right. And also, one last thing, as you mentioned, being comfortable, I have the luxury of being able to do the vocals when I wanted. I didn't have to go in, you know, paid studio time and have to get the tracks done because I was afraid of losing money or having to pay more. You know, it's just a more relaxed atmosphere. And if I wasn't feeling it one day, I could just shut it down and say, you know what, I'm going to try tomorrow. You know, so it was just a cool process, and I actually really dig it.
I think all that does have a lot to do with the strength in your voice, but you just sound great on this disc, Ronny.
Thanks for pointing that out. I appreciate it.
Okay, so now I love this album, and no doubt metalheads everywhere are going to love this disc too. But it really doesn't matter what we think. The question is, are you happy with the way the album turned out? Is this the album you wanted to make?
Good question, and yes it is, like I said. And I've listened to this thing repeatedly, and I normally don't like to listen to myself. I think that holds true for a lot of musicians, but once I'm done with something, I generally really don't go back and listen to it that often, except for reference points for maybe for touring and whatnot. But this record is, yeah, I'm excited, man. I think it's a very, very good record. it's the best record that I've done, in my opinion. And the songs are well written. There's hooks, melodies. You know, it's everything that I wanted. I had high expectations because, of course, I wanted to top the Fire Within. And, you know, I couldn't be prouder of this.
Yeah, no, I think you've done that. All right, now, Ronnie, Lords of the Edge has 12 blistering metal tracks, and I wondered if we could briefly go through the songs. Like, perhaps you could give us a bit of insight into each of them. Are you game?
Yeah, I can do that. You know, I want to start off by saying that, you know, with this one, like, the stuff that I wrote with Metal Church and even The Fire Within, I've really always, my lyrical content has always kind of been a little bit about religion, politics, my dislikes of the things that are going on in the world, the negative things, and all that, and kind of maybe thought-provoking stuff, I would like to think. But on this one, I was like, you know, I'm going to loosen up a bit. There is still some of that same kind of thing on this, but there's also some songs that are just fun. They were just fun for me. So, you know, yeah, I'll go ahead and break it down for you a little bit.
All right, well, let's start off with the first track, Just Breathe, which I played prior to our interview. Tell us a bit about that.
Okay, well, this one basically is, you know, about pushing through diversity, you know, with a positive attitude, being able to relax, you know, a little bit, and finally being able to breathe, you know, once you have worked really hard at something. And basically that's the kind of the gist of that one.
Okay, and the second track, Full Circle, which is my number one fave off the album.
Oh, cool. Now, this one is basically about you know, going back to places that you've already been, but in a different light or in a better way, with more knowledge. So you don't make the same mistakes again. That's what that one's about.
Okay, cool. Pierced by the Maiden?
Okay, well, here we go with kind of Dungeons and Dragons stuff. This was one of the fun ones, basically, where I just said, I actually got a hold of Stu and I said, hey, man, I want this certain kind of song. Can you give me something? And sure enough, the next day he sent me the song, and what came out was Kings and Queens and Evil Deeds. That's what that's about, just having fun. And the Kings and Queens thing really stemmed probably from something I was watching on History Channel, because I'm a big fan of the History Channel and things like that. So that's what that one's about.
All right, cool. Now, what about track four?
It's about the History Channel, but it's about Kings and Queens. Anyway.
All right, well, now, what about track four, The Vision?
This one I really, really like. You know, this is kind of the Cross the Sea of Souls, you know, if you will, that was on The Fire Within, kind of ballad-esque. It says in the song, in the chorus, the vision isn't simple, but yet it's not so hard. And what I'm talking about here is, you know, why can't we just pull our heads out of our asses and make this world a better place? It just seems that we're all too busy. Well, maybe not all of us. There are many, many great people on this earth. But anyway, I don't want to get too deep on it. It's just kind of me wanting the world to be a better place. It's the vision.
All right, cool. Now, what about track five, The Fear of What's to Come?
Well, this one really is about kind of stemmed from the Mayan prophecy and all that. You know, basically people's fascination with the end of the earth or end of life. And I just say, you know, live your life and don't worry about it, because when it does happen, there's nothing that we're going to be able to do about it. So why worry about things that you cannot control? Just live your life to the best, you know, to the fullest and the best you can. Just be a good human being.
Yeah, that's totally cool. What about Let Them Feed? Now, this is the free download I was mentioning earlier on the show. If people visit ratpackrecords.com/Ronnie Munroe, they can actually download Let Them Feed for free. But I believe this is only going to be up while the pre-orders are in effect. So I think it'll end sometime around the middle of October. So if anybody wants to get a download of this song, you should do it now before, I guess, around October 15th, 18th, something like that. So tell us about that one, because it's kind of a fun song, eh?
Well, yeah, this is one of the ones I was talking about, and I've got one word about this song. It's about zombies.
Yeah.
That's it. You know, what came out first, the first line was basically, okay, this is about zombies. That's it.
Yeah, it's a fun song. All right, track seven, Rock and a Hard Place.
Okay, yeah, this actually is the song that Chris Caffery contributed, which is a killer song. I love the screams on the intro and his guitar playing, and just the aggressiveness of this song is very, very cool. And it's about road rage. Simple as that.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome.
Well, hopefully, you know, some people will be able to listen to it while they're driving and maybe calm them down. Hopefully not make them more angry.
All right. What about Blood Red Sun?
This is a song that actually Rick Van Zant contributed, and basically I wanted to get this out there as well. This was the first song that really started the record.
Really?
He gave me this, he gave me this song a couple years ago, actually, and I had it out there in my iTunes and kind of was waiting for the next record to start up, and it was really the first one that I kind of started working on. But the song is about war and man's need for it, you know, man's need for power and corruption and just all that kind of stuff. But I really dig this one. I really love the intro, especially.
Mm-hmm. Now, what about the title track, Lords of the Edge, which is track 9 on the disc?
Well, you know what? Just like I gave the explanation about what Lords of the Edge means to me, It's basically the same. You know, even existing in today's world, you're a Lord of the Edge. Or if you take a lot of risks or chances in life, you know, good risks and chances, that is, to better yourself, then you're a Lord of the Edge.
Okay, and how about Touched by a Demon?
Touched by a Demon, which is kind of my ode to Ronny Dio, really, in the 7 years. That's kind of feel that I got. I wanted a song kind of like that. And this one is, you know, Touched by a Demon. Kind of when you're just out and about and you meet new people, and I'm sure you, like everyone else, has ran across people that they've met, that some people just seem a little evil. And, you know, in all truth, and to me at least.
No, I agree.
What the song is about. You know, you meet certain people and they're just not good people, and you see something in them that, may, at least for me, makes me not want to be associated with them. And I know I've met a few people like that in this industry as well as in everyday life, and I steer clear of them.
Yeah, I'm sure you have. Now, what about Still Alive? This is another one of my favorites. I really like that track.
You know, this one here has a lot of meaning for me. I played this on acoustic, and one of the first things that I wrote, you know, musically when I started playing guitar, and the lyrics go to, they're owed to my mother and father who both passed away. You know, it just says, you're still alive while you're here. And when you lose a loved one or somebody just very close to you, of course you take that time to grieve. But, you know, I'm pretty dang sure that if they're looking down from you and, you know, and watching you go through things, like I went through a really rough time after my mom passed. And I'm sure that if she, you know, could have reached down and just grabbed me by my hair and slapped the crap out of me, she would have, just to say, look, you know, I'm gone, but I'm always in your heart. And while you're still alive, live your life. Don't worry about me. I'm in a better place. Just continue to live and be the best person you can be. So that's what the song is about.
Yeah, I love that one. It really is one of my favorites. And another is track 12, Goodbye to the Black. This is a bonus track. I love this partly because it's different, a little different from most of the songs. It's a good old rock and roll tune. Tell me about that one.
Yeah, and I think the same thing. You know, it's like a hard rock song and this and that. And I actually wrote that intro on a 12-string.
Did you really?
Originally, yeah. And then, of course, gave it over to Stu, and Stu worked his magic with it. And, of course, Michael Wilton did a blazing solo on this one, as well as Stu. But Whip's got the main solo on here. And Goodbye to the Black, the meaning behind it is just saying goodbye to the negative forces in your life. That's what the black is. The black is the negative forces, and that's it. You know, just trying to be a better, more positive person and overcoming the obstacles.
All right. Well, cool. Thanks, Ronny. Thanks for going over those with me because, you know, it's a new disc. I think it's important that people get an idea of what your thoughts were on them. That's really awesome. Thank you.
With that said about my meanings behind the songs, I'm curious, you know, so when the listeners pick up the disc, you know, I'm going to say something here I haven't said before. Feel free to go to my Facebook or the Rat Pack Facebook or whatever it is and let me know what you think the meanings of the songs are. That's what I wanted to say.
Cool. Well, because it's going to have a different meaning for everyone, right?
Exactly. That's why I said that, because I'm curious of what other people think. So feel free.
Okay, cool. Now, I know the album is new and fresh, but I wondered if you had a personal favorite off Lords of the Edge, and if so, which one and why?
Well, everyone always says that I love all of them, but it's the truth. I think every track on this rocks, but you know, I like The Vision. I like Full Circle. Like I said, I like all of them.
Yeah.
But one that I seem to be going back to is The Vision.
Okay.
Because I really love the melody line. I love the hooks. So yeah, Division, I think, is my favorite.
Okay, fair enough. So, Ronny, I also wanted to talk to you about that pre-order, because not only can people pre-order the CD, there's also a special package that Rat Pack Records has available, and it's the Lords of the Edge CD, and also a hand-autographed 11x17 Ronny Munroe poster and a limited edition Lords of the Edge t-shirt. I was going to ask you now, are these posters hand-autographed? You personally autograph them? They're not stenciled?
Yeah, actually, the posters are signed by me. Basically, Rat Pack just sent them over to me, I signed them, and sent them back. So, yeah, personally autographed, and you get the shirt and the disc. And like you said, the shirt is a limited edition. And from what I've been told, which I'm very happy about, the pre-orders are going like, hotcakes, like that. They're going pretty well, so I'm really stoked about that. So, pick one up as soon as you can, today.
Yeah, today would be a good day, because I have heard that they are going fast. There's just a limited amount of t-shirts and posters left, and the CD is just flying off the shelves. And apparently the bundle is $19.95, which is a pretty cool deal to get the CD, an autographed poster, and a limited edition Lords of the Edge t-shirt. I think that's a great price. And the CD is available for $10.95. So get your copy now. And really, you guys are going to love this disc. Metal fans are just going to eat this up, Ronny. It's a great disc.
Well, thank you so much. I wanted to send out thank you to Joe Brian from Rat Pack as well, because I commend him on that for keeping the prices low. And I think that is a great deal, $19.95 for the poster, CD, and shirt. And, you know, right now times are tough, so that's right. Very cool of him. So, yes. Pick it up today if you can, and hey, let me know what you think about the material.
Yeah, in this recession, that is a good price. Now, I know if you type Ronny Munroe into Google, reams of stuff comes up about you, but are there any sites in particular you'd like to get out there today, Ronny?
All of them that I have. You know, there's MySpace, which is still alive, we hope. Facebook, Reverb Nation, Twitter. So, yeah, I'm on all of those. And also the big one is RonnyMunroe.com, which has been revamped and I think looks pretty cool. And you can get all your information on there. And actually, all the links to all my other sites will be on RonnyMunroe.com. And also, you always can go to RatPackRecords.com because you can find me on there, definitely. And there's other cool stuff on there, you know, from other people on Rat Pack as well, like Jason Bittner and Whip. Check it out when you get a chance.
Okay, cool. I have a feeling we're going to be hearing a lot more from Ronny Munroe before the year is out, but is there anything else that you'd like to add that I didn't ask you this evening, or any messages for your fans out there, Ronny?
Well, sure. You know, as always, I really dig my fans. I really do, and I consider them friends, really. As cheesy as that may sound, it's the truth, because I do my best to respond to emails and whatnot, and I get quite a few, and I've, you know, struck up some friendships with people, and I just think that's really cool. And one thing I'm blessed with is for people to even be interested in my music and like my music. And it's the fans that allow me to even continue to do this. You know, I mean, of course, I would be doing music anyway, regardless, but it's the fans that keep me going. So I really appreciate everyone. And, I appreciate everyone giving me the support.
Awesome.
Pick up the record. This kicks ass.
It does kick ass. Thanks once again for all your time, Ronny. Best of luck with your new solo release, Lords of the Edge. And you know I'm wishing you continued success.
Oh, thank you very much, Tina. It's always a pleasure to be on your show, and you do a great job on this thing as well. I wanted to say that. And everybody, hey, have a good day, and hope to see you out on the road real soon. Hey, Metalheads. This is Ronny Munroe, and you are listening to the one and only Tina Peak on the Big Rock Show.
You're lost in the desert, heading for early decay.
The Big Rock Show. New music, interviews, and much more. Find us at thebigrockshow.net or on Facebook, facebook.com/TheBigRockShow. The Big Rock Show, baby. Oh, yeah.